Yeah, hi all, and welcome back to my channel. On this video, I just want to show you the difference between a Leopard CPU and just some stock CPUs. I was here now testing around. I have salt temperatures, guys. You're gonna get crazy. I'm gonna show you more tomorrow. I got your temperatures, which are nearly about 10 degrees better as on my last videos where I was just testing the thermal pastes for you guys. I hope you can remember that. So in the last, I think, two videos, I think yesterday it was, I have just done a test with some thermal pastes, and the results right now, I have just done a quick test for me. Oh my God, guys, but I will not talk about that. Tomorrow, you're gonna see more. Now it's just very late. As you can see, I have not just left it again with 1000 paper because this was really just too much polish, and that's you just need to go here with your fingernail and then you have a scratch because this was just really like a mirror, and I have just done it for me perfectly that I can just use it all the days, and so otherwise you will just be angry when you just scratch it all the time because you just need to put it one time back and then you close the cooler and you will see a small scratch, and that's why it was good for the video. I just wanted to show you that you can really get a CPU like this really shiny and really like a mirror, and this was just the best proof that you can still do that without problem. But now I'm here to show you the difference between a Leopard CPU, and here I'm gonna also show you why this guy is working on about 10 degrees cooler as all the others here. But now I can't, yeah, I just want to tell you what I have prepared here for you. I got here a cooler, which is a stock cooler from Intel. On the back, I got a light, and we're gonna now be able to see through the, yeah, through the CPU between the cooler, okay? And that's why I have just prepared it like that, and I now need just to get the smartphone in the, you wait, in the tripod in, inside. It will maybe be difficult for me to record this all, but I think somehow we're gonna just get it work. So give me a second, guys, I need just to adjust this all. And then of course we're gonna need also lots of zoom. So let me now get here a little bit down, because really, guys, I'm just doing this here for you now. So let me get here a little bit down, and maybe here also, wait. Yes, it looks good. We called God. Wait. Yes, I think this could be great. Wait. So, okay. Now I need to go to the front. Yeah, we need to go a little bit more down, guys. You're gonna love this. You're gonna love this. I promise you guys. So. So let me just fix it all, and maybe here a little bit more, and then we are nearly finished. So focus, autofocus, yes. Oh yes, now it's great. So wait. Okay. So of course this is not just too bright, but I have just done it for purpose. Okay, I'm gonna now begin just with, I don't know, let's go for this one. This is an Intel Xeon X5470, and you can see it's looking, yeah, brand new. Yeah, it looks really new, no scratches. Wow, huh? Not bad. So I'm gonna now just put it over there, take a look now closely. So okay, can you see what I see, guys? Are you able to see that shit, what I see? Okay, I'm gonna zoom a little bit more. All right. I think I need to go a little bit more down. Just a little bit. Give me a second, guys. Okay, should be like that. I'm trying a little bit to get it better working. I think this is the position that I need. Wait. Okay, guys. Let's give it a try again. Look, the lights, which you can see in the middle. You see that? Sometimes, yeah, wait. Oh my God. This is now the, how it calls, the air between the CPU and how it calls the cooler. Okay, wait, I'm trying to zoom a little bit back because too much zoom is not so good and you're gonna just see that all a little bit, yeah, let's say not that sharp as I just wish. So let's go a little bit here. I think it's okay right now. So that means when I just turn this bad guy to this side, you see no lights because, yeah, it's nearly in the line. But in the middle, when you just turn it to the other side, you can see that we got here some air under there. That means that the CPU, it just makes like that, okay? It's just bending. If you see my last video, where I have just lapped CPU, you was able to see also where the CPU begins to get loose the paint. I'm gonna now start my other computer just quickly. And then I'm gonna show you that on my YouTube video. But this is now just that you can see why the CPU is running hot. And I'm really not kidding. I was now just making here some benchmarks on my Leopard CPU, and I can still remember yesterday with Thermal Grizzly Cryonaut, we have done a benchmark and the maximum temperatures was 71 degrees. I have done now really the same with the Cryonaut from Thermal Grizzly, but this time with my Leopard CPU. And I can tell you one thing, guys, I was maximum on 60 degrees. So that means this is about 10 till 11 degrees better results as stock, or let's say as on the original CPU, not Leopard CPU. Now, I'm gonna take another one. I'm gonna put this away. I got here now another one, just that you guys can see. And I'm gonna put this away, okay? Later you're gonna see that I really have put it away, but now I just need this camera. I'm gonna put it somewhere there. Let's go now for an E2140. So let me not just look and see. This one looks good till now. Let's turn him. And we got here the same problem. You can see that? In the middle, we got again a lot of light. Okay, wait. I'm gonna try to show you that. Yeah, in the middle, you can see this light. Okay. And I'm really nice in the middle. Maybe I could move the smartphone lights a little bit more to the other side. Let me not just try to move this here. Oh, but it's okay. It's all fine. So you can see the lights are getting under there. Look at this shit. And the most CPUs are like that. the most hitch breeders are like that. With the time, they get really just shitty. So now I'm gonna just take this also just away. Oops, sorry again. Just want the best lights here for this video. Okay, we got here. Ah, yeah, this was just the Q6600 that I had before. Just a little bit, how it calls, polish it, but not really lap it. Okay, this was just a little bit because it had some scratches. This is a very, very old Q6600, but I have not really lap it. This was just, for the other scratches that I had. We're gonna now just put this one here over there. And look there, again, the same stuff. Okay, look. I'm gonna now turn it also to the other side, and here maybe. Look, so much light, man. Okay. This is just stock. I haven't done nothing here. I have maybe just polished it, and I just want to to tell you that with the time, the heat spreaders, because of the pressure or because that it's maybe glued, this side is not so terrible. You can see that? Wait. But look on the other side. Oh, it was the other side. Sorry, my fault. So. Okay. You can really see that we got lights here. I'm gonna try to press it down with lots of power, and you see nothing is changing. So when you close your cooler with lots of pressure, that means the pressure is still not enough, because you're gonna need to bend this guy to have really contact under there. So it was already again somewhere. See that? So now I'm in the middle, and here a little bit. See that? Somewhere, yeah, here. But I just want to show you this, that one side is always terrible. Look, this is a shame, guys. I'm gonna now press here down. You can see it happens nothing. You can see on my fingers, I'm pressing with a lot of power. Look on my fingers here on the top. Look how I press it down. Look, and it happens nothing. The pressure will just not get it down really, because it's just too bended. The heat spreader here is just bended like hell. And the most processors are like this. So let's go now for an E7500. Let's put him over there and let's check this one out. And the same again. Look. Wait. Yeah, it was quickly. Let me turn this guy again. And we got here again the problem. It's always the same thing. And I'm gonna show you later on my YouTube video where the problem is. And then you're gonna see that I'm right. Why should I be wrong? So here, I'm gonna press it other down again, no change. So when I turn him to the other side, perfectly to the other side, we should have the same problem here. Look. And I can tell you why. And this is why your CPU is running about 10 degrees hotter. I'm gonna prove this all tomorrow. Now let's just put this away too. Let's go here for, what is this? This is the Q8200, brand new, or nearly like new, because this ones, they are very old. These CPUs are very old, of course, but you can see, no scratches. Like new, nearly. Let's put him over there too. So, let me see if this is all just in the middle. Yes, it looks like. So this one here, oh, sorry, my fault. This one here again on this side, I cannot see so much. A little bit just, but again, let's turn in. And here we go. The same thing. Again in the middle. You see that? And I really need to press a lot to get the pressure down or to get the CPU down. Can you see that? Yeah, so now you can see that maybe better. See that? Yeah, now you can see that better. Look. And I'm really in the middle. Let's turn it again. It should be better. Yes. So it's always just one side. And this side is always bended. So here again, you can see now the lights under there. Here, see that? You get this in the middle again. Should be here. It's always the same. So the Q8200 was, I think, till now one of the best, but still I can see lights. I'm going to put this bad guy to the right side. It was more or less a little bit better. So what's here? X5450. I'm going to put this as over there. Looks good for now. This is not bad. This one is not bad. Nice. This is a Xeon. This one is a Xeon. Intel Xeon. Looks nice. So that means the quality here is a little bit better. Yeah, I'm happy with it. I'm going to put it also to the right side. So, and what's here? Again, one. X5450. I got two. So, I don't want that you just think some shit. Let's put this guy here. As over there. And here I can see again the lights. See that? Look, wait, sometimes it's just bad. It's not that much, but sometimes, let's turn him. Sometimes it gets even worse or worse. But this side looks that it's, I don't know. We got again some lights. I'm gonna press it down again. Yeah, so this guy seems to be a little bit better. As I press it down, it gets a little bit better, but still not so much. I need really to press it with a lot of power. You can see that on my finger sometimes. Yeah, so we have here maybe just two that are in a great condition, and all the rest of the CPUs that I have just showed you, they have all this issue with the lights inside or under there. Look, again one. Oh man. And now you know why I have just labeled it. Let's put this away. Now let's check my labeled CPU. This is the CPU that I have just labeled today. Let's get him over there. Let's turn this bad guy. You can see there's nothing. I hope you guys are able to see that. Okay. And I'm really turning it to all the sides. Oh, I need to sit a little bit different. My legs. So, again, let's zoom a little bit deeper. Okay, guys, take a look. I'm not kidding. This CPU is just sitting perfect. Let's turn it again. Look, just a little bit and you can see some lights. See that? Just if I move a little bit. But when I just put it back together, it should be no lights. And this is here. Perfect. Okay? But if I just move here on the right side, just a little bit. Look, 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 look. Have you seen that? Okay, this is my Leopard CPU, which I have just done today. Okay, perfect. Wanna zoom back a little bit more? And here, wait, just as you really can see, look how many CPUs there was just wrong. Okay, so I'm gonna here, let me see. See if I can zoom even more back. So here, I'm gonna put my Leopard one here. Now let's get again one like this. I'm gonna put it just over there. And let's zoom in again. Here you can see again the lights. See that? I'm even pressing it down and it's had nothing. This is now normally in the middle, but you can see there's a problem. Let's turn it again to this side. Here it looks again a little bit better. Now let's turn again to this side. Whoa, sorry, my fault. Here we go. And here. Yeah, we got again here the light. You see that? Oh man. And this is what I wanted to show you. I'm gonna go now with you to the computer because I have saw today the problem on the CPUs. Let's turn it again. Yeah, here again. See that? And a lot of CPUs are like that, guys. I'm not kidding. I'm going to show you now that this CPU is really sitting in the middle. And you guys, you need to show that, okay? You need to see that, I mean. Look, I'm pressing it down, nothing happens. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna now take the camera. Oops, my fault. Just that you guys can see that this was really just. Come on. That this was really just perfect. And the lights here. Could be better adjusted, but this is just really how it calls hard for me. So wait here. So now you can see that way better. Look at this. This is a shame, guys. Okay, look at this. Yeah, this side is maybe better. But this is a shame at last, it's a shame. Look. So, and this was now one from a lot. Let's check this one again, once of this. Look on the left side here. Look all here on this left side. Yeah. Now you know why lapping is great. Nothing, look. Look at this shit. So the light was just bad from the camera that I had on my tripod. So when I just do it myself, I can look better through the light. So these CPUs are all just a shame, guys. Okay. And it's not the cooler, because my cooler is great. I'm gonna show you this later, that my cooler is great. So here one more shitty CPU. We got three left. So, and here one more, I can see it already. See that? Yeah, focus is not always so great, but it's okay, you can see the lights. And here I can still see the lights. Pressing it down with a lot of pressure, but nothing happens, just maybe a little bit. But this is what I wanted to show you. Even if you just get your cooler inside, the pressure will not be enough to get the CPU really touched to the cooler, if you understand what I mean. So let's go for this one. I think this one was the Xeon, huh? Ah, but this is, yeah, also the same shit. Wait, I think the Xeons was a little bit better. Let's turn this guy. Yeah, maybe a little bit just. But I'm happy with this one. I'm happy with this one. It's not that bad. So, is this the Xeon? Let me see. Yes, and then we got one more. I think this was also the Xeon, the Q8200. Looks good till now. Yes, the Q8200 looks also good. Okay, you can see that way, really great. Gonna turn it. Ah, here we got it. Yeah. Okay, the Q8200 has the same problem. I'm gonna show you, like I told you, the problem now, and then you're gonna see what I mean. And a lot of CPUs has this. Also the newest, really the newest. I'm talking here about, I don't know, socket 2011 and some more. Here again, for my Leopard one. Let's just put this one here. This is now the Leopard guy. The one that I just have done today, guys. And you can really see it's just sitting perfectly in the middle. Just wanted you guys just, yeah, believe me. Now I'm gonna turn this bad guy too. And also when I just turn it, it feels so good. It feels so good when I just turn it. I can feel how... how soft I can turn it. You see that? Nothing. And that's why I have Leopard. Well, let me stand up a little bit. Okay. Yeah, guys, I think this has shown you a lot of proof right now here. And you can see when it's just hot calls. So polish it. Yeah. When it just have. Polish it too much, like a mirror, you just get it one time back and then you have some small scratches. That's why I have now just lapped it with 1000 and I have not polished it anymore. Because yeah, it's just too much when you just polish it too much and it looks like a mirror. But if you take your fingernail and you just touch it one time, you're gonna see a scratch. So if not, just polish it with 1000 paper or just with the stuff like this. You see that? And then this is just perfect. So the most important is that you're gonna lap it on a glass table or with a glass. That it's gonna be really perfect. Okay, let's not just take. Let's take this one. I don't care. Just again for you guys. So okay. I think I don't need to say anything more. Now I'm gonna put it back again. Let's take mine. And let's put it back again. Okay. I don't need to say anything else. See that? Let's turn it also. Nothing, no lights, just perfect. Okay, again, just that you guys can compare. Put in the middle. Oh, and turn him, because the problem is when you just turn him. And here we go again. Okay, so here, a lot of lights. This is the big problem, okay? Just look. Nice. Okay, really in the middle. All perfect. But look. Okay, let's go to the computer right now. Because I just want to finish this video also. And then I'm gonna show you the problem. So. Let's get here into the video. And here. Here it was. So, give me a second. Here. Wait. But you can see it already here. Wait. So here, let me just get a quick, a great point to pause. What have I done? Oh man, oh yeah. So I'm sorry, guys. Here, pause. What the hell? Ah, my fault. Not here, here's pause. I get tired. Sorry, guys. Sorry. Please forgive me. So now I'm gonna pause. So you can see here. Yes. Here in the middle, you can see it comes first. And then here, right. And here, left. Later, you're gonna see it. We still have the look. Best pick ever. Okay. And that's how they are. And that's why you can see the lights here through. If you just turn the bad guy to the other side, then of course you're gonna not see the lights, because if the light just comes from that side, of course it's okay, because the CPUs, yeah, they are here a little bit better. But at last, the CPUs, they are just like that, you know, and not that. And that's why. If you lap it, it gets so. How can I call? Here you got still too much. You understand what I mean? I hope. See that? Look at this picture also. You can see still here and here and here a lot. So that means that this CPU was really like that. Okay. And this problem also, you got also a lot on your PlayStation 3. The aluminium cooler, sometimes they are really just made like that. I had a PlayStation that was like that. I don't know if I'm gonna find this video again. PS3 overheating. After IHS or something like that. Wait, here it was, yeah. So here, this is also a video from me, and I have show here how, yeah, look, the same thing. I had the PlayStation here from a guy, and it was overheating, so he told me if I can remove the heat spreaders and stuff. And yeah, I have done my work. I have removed the heat spreaders. I have just put the heat spreaders back, like you can see. But then I still saw a big problem. And the big problem here in this case was the aluminum cooler. Okay. And the aluminum cooler was just bended. And that's why I had to repair it. See that? And yeah, it was just like that. I have also here explained it on the video, and I have really told the people what the problem was inside. So I don't know if I can, if I'm gonna have some lights again, but the problem was that. And after I have just left it there, I have just grinded a little bit. After that, the PlayStation was working nice. So then I have made some tests for myself, and here I still have saw that something is not great. And then I think somewhere later, I have, yeah, here I have show you now, where it's just still too much metal, you see? And that's why the cooling was really bad. And later I think I have just left it all, then I have just made the test, temperature test, it was all okay, God thanks. Because I had really to lap there, and I think it was here. Here I have just removed the heat spreaders. I think I have explained some stuff there also. And then I have checked the heat spreader itself. This one, it was looking great, because I have just tested also with the lights. But this one here, you can see, just bad. Look at this. Look at this, my friend. So that means right and left, it was just banded, you see, just like whoop, whoop. And yeah, this is all that I just wanted to show you, the same thing we got on this CPUs. And then I have lapped it. I have here just tried to fix it, and at last, yes, I have got it work again. But yeah, this was all for me, guys, and I just wanted to tell you that tomorrow I'm gonna show you great stuff, guys, great temperatures, you're gonna not believe. And then we can also compare between the temperatures. Wait, was here the last video? Was it the last? No, the, yeah, here on this video, also with the Q6600, I had here temperatures on about 70 degrees, guys, not kidding. Look here, you just remember that, 70 degrees after 10 minutes prime 95. And you guys, please just remember this number here, otherwise you can all the time look on this video. And I'm gonna promise you tomorrow that my CPU right now, as I have lapped it, I have tested for me, it was running maximum on 60. So that means we got, you know, 10 degrees better temperatures, guys, just because I have lapped it, and because now the thermal paste is everywhere on the cooler. And of course, yesterday I have done it here just with a dot method, with a P method, you know, the thermal paste. And I have just done a test, a quick test for me, for myself, where I have just put everywhere thermal paste on the cooler itself. So the first is we got everywhere thermal paste, and the second thing is the CPU is lapped and it's just sitting perfectly on the cooler. And that's why I was able to get 10 till 11 degrees better temperatures. But this and more I'm going to show you tomorrow, okay? So don't forget here the temperatures, otherwise you can just go all the time here on this video, and then we're going to do a compare, and then you're gonna be able to see the difference. Okay, guys, this was all for me. NSC in the place to be. I'm very tired, and yeah, now I'm off to bed. I need a rest. See ya soon. Stay strong, and bye bye.